This cathedral church, so named because it houses the throne, or cathedra, of the Bishop of Winchester, has its origins in the 7th century, when a Christian church was first built on the site. Begun in 1079, in the Romanesque style, this cathedral is at the heart of Alfred's Wessex in a diocese which once stretched from London's Thames to the Channel Islands. Its bishops were men of enormous wealth and power, none more so than William of Wykeham, twice Chancellor of England, founder of Winchester College and New College, Oxford. The chantry chapels and memorials of these great prelates are a feature of the cathedral. These influential bishops also developed, refashioned and adorned this great cathedral. Their pilgrims sought the shrine of local saints, notably a former bishop, St. Swithin, whose festival, 15th of July, was said to set the pattern for the weather for the next 40 days. The cathedral was also the church of the community of Benedictine monks from its earliest days. Elements of the monastic buildings may still be traced through the cathedral close. Central to the life of the monks was the Opus Dei, the work of God, the regular offering of prayer which they sang in the choir. The discipline of praying regularly for the world is continued today. Evensong still takes place in the choir of the cathedral. The choristalls with their magnificent gabled canopies, elaborately carved with flowers and plants, owls and monkeys, dragons and knights. It is well known to the people out and around Winchester that the cathedral is haunted by a group of three monks, and also a limping monk, seen on several occasions around Abbey Gardens. Disappearing at the knees, these phantom monks reportedly walk on the original floor of the building. In 1957, a photographer caught several male figures dressed in medieval robes. The limping monk has been seen around Cathedral Close. This brown-colored entity hobbles down the closed street. There are several haunted locations in Winchester near the town center, one of which is the Eclipse Inn. This ancient public house owes its origins to the pilgrims that visited the nearby shrine of St. Swithin. In the 1350s, enterprising residents of the high street started selling souvenirs. Food and drink was served to pilgrims from the bottom of their gardens. These stalls eventually became permanent shops and inns to form what is now the square. In about 1540, the present building was erected. The central siding of the fireplace is typical of a house of this period. Almost all of the timbers are original. The way it has been worked, the decoration ceases towards one end, suggests that it was recycled from another building, or perhaps a ship. During the Eclipse's long history, the building has been a private house, a rectory, to the Church of St. Lawrence, an alehouse, in 1750, and finally in pub in the 1800s. An apparition of a grey lady has reputedly been seen several times in one of the corridors upstairs, and this apparition is said to be Dame Alice Lyle of Moyle's Court. Lady Lyle was executed on 2nd of September 1685 in Winchester Marketplace for harboring raiders following the failed Monmouth Rebellion. The Grey Lady reputedly walks along the corridor on which the room Alice spent her last night can be found. The former offices of the county's oldest newspaper date back to the 18th century, so it is perhaps not surprising that there is a ghost. It is apparently a woman, and she is heard more than seen, usually rattling chains or machinery in the High Street building. The ghost was last seen in October 2001. The Chronicle's own pet ghost, nicely in time for Halloween. Sub-editor Leslie Park had the surprise of her life when she encountered the specter in the corridors of the Hampshire Chronicle. It was 6:30 p.m., and I was getting ready to go home. I was making my way towards the advertising offices when I saw what I took to be a man standing at the table outside the file room. He appeared to be studying a pile of newspapers. As I watched, The figure turned as if to walk into the file room, which was locked. But when I got to the corridor leading to the file room, he had gone. Next week, we will be visiting Bishop's Waltham.